gastroesophageal junction, it's got a physiological sphincter, which is very, very important to prevent the reflux of contents going from the stomach in a retrograde way into the esophagus. When it happens, due to whatever is the reason, it is called as a gastroesophageal reflux disease. For this reflux disease, it is a very common thing abroad, but whereas it's not that common in our country, but we keep seeing more patients in the US. What are the symptoms of these patients? They usually complain of dyspeptic symptoms, plus they complain of heartburn. That is one of the commonest things. They land up with the cardiologist thinking that it is due to the heart problem. When after investigation, then they come to us to show that it is due to the gastroesophageal reflux disease. The test available for this are, best thing is upper GI endoscopy with impedance manometry. Why impedance manometry is? Impedance manometry will show whether it is an acid reflux or a bile reflux. Previously, we used to do only the pH manometry that don't give the alkaline reflux, but this gives a very good information about the gastroesophageal acid and alkaline reflux. Having diagnosed a case of gastroesophageal symptomatic reflux disease by endoscopy and by impedance manometry, what do you do? We first advise them lifestyle changes. That is, like if they are smokers, you advise them to stop smoking. If they are obese, you advise them to lose weight. And if they take the dietary habits after the food, we advise them to just for a half an hour or so to sit. And apart from this, the best management is proton pump inhibitors. Proton pump inhibitors with motility drugs are greatly helpful. If you add a motility drug, the esophageal motility is increased and the stasis in the esophageal area will decrease. And plus, in addition, with the proton pump inhibitors, acid is decreased, acid reflux becomes less effective on the esophageal mucosa. So the combination of proton pump inhibitors and the motility drugs is the choice for the gastroesophageal reflux disease management, in addition to the lifestyle changes. But once you use this medicine, there are two ways of doing it. You take it continuously or you use it on demand. But after some time, some of these patients will come and start saying that I'm not getting the desired relief. Whatever the time you've taken, you increase the dose to 2 times a day rather than once a day. Then most of them will get relief with the proton pump inhibitors. But in a small group of patients who develop complications, they require surgical management. What type of surgery we do? We tend to enhance the gastroesophageal junction by taking the fundal wrap. The commonest fundal wrap we do is the 360 degrees nasal fundoplication. The mechanism how it works is, when the food goes into the stomach dilates. The dilated stomach fundus, which is wrapped around the gastroesophageal junction, distends and keeps the esophageal sphincter closed. That's how the reflux is prevented from the stomach into the esophagus. This fundoplication we do for those patients who are not responding to treatment with proton pump inhibitors. Proton pump inhibitors are the drugs of choice in the gastroesophageal reflux disease management, in addition to lifestyle changes.